Now to the deadly trench collapse in Kenosha County. A worker was buried waist deep and a rescue crew desperately tried to free him. The trench gave way, killing him.
12 News' Brendan Conway is live in the town of Summers where the story has been unfolding all day. And Brendan, crews are getting close to recovering the man's body.
Yeah, Terry, I talked to the fire chief a short time ago. He says he thinks they'll be able to recover Juan Oviedo's body around 11 o'clock tonight. They removed about 8 feet of debris, water, and mud a short time ago, and they're able to locate exactly where he was. Now, as you guys mentioned, this initial recovery effort started out optimistically. They were able to move all that dirt. He was down to his chest. They thought he would be freed, and that's when things took a deadly turn.
He was just like anybody's perfect friend.
That's how Eric Richter will remember his cousin Juan Oviedo.
You need help with anything, you give Juan a call. And that's how he was. He'd help anybody.
Oviedo died when a trench he was working in caved in. Emergency crews worked frantically to free the 52-year-old. At one point, when the mud was to Oviedo's chest, they thought he would be saved. But around 11 a.m., the earth gave way.
They were just getting ready for Christmas, and unfortunately, this happened.
Oviedo, a longtime construction worker, was laying sewer pipe to a new shopping mall development off of Green Bay Road when mud caved in below his protective trench box. Oviedo was working for A.W. Oaks & Sons Construction Company out of Racine. The company declined to comment, but his cousin says he knew he had a dangerous job.
There's tricks of the trades that they have to know, but I don't think anyone would expect this to happen.
As crews worked to recover Oviedo's body, they ran into problems. Groundwater and mud kept filling the hole, forcing them to bring in 20-foot-long steel plates to shore up the trench. Workers say despite the cold and everything they've been through, they are not leaving until their job is done.
For now, we're concentrating on getting our job done and trying to put an end to this for us and the family.
Cold weather's also caused some problems here. The chief says that they've actually had 150 people here working in shifts of in and about 20 minutes. They go into some warming buses for about 45 minutes. People from as far away as Illinois have been coming here to try to help them recover this body. They also say that here in the last few hours, as the temperatures have dropped, some of their equipment has been having some problems. But again, they say they're going to stay at it until they finally are able to recover his body. Terry?
Obviously, the family is shaken. So are the crews out there trying to help in this situation. Do we have any idea how this happened?
No, and OSHA right now is going to be the lead investigative agency. They've been on site all day. The fire chief says he's not dealing with that. His job is to recover this body, but OSHA is out here. Medical examiner also expected to start their investigation tomorrow to find out how this could have happened. Could it have been prevented? All those answers probably still months away.
All right.